Good morning. It is Saturday, April 23, 2022, and it is 1:28 p.m., about 1:30 p.m. Pacific time. I hope you're doing well. I hope you're having a good day. And this is going to be a little bit longer video today. And I have an idea what I'm going to cover, but just kind of leave it up to God. And Lord, bless this time together in your word and talking. And lead and guide in the name of Jesus. Amen. So first of all, I'm going to go over here to Psalm 111, King James Version, public domain. Read a little bit of this. You can always read more on your own, of course, or other places in the Bible. You don't have to do what I'm doing, okay? But I do encourage you to read the Bible, okay, on your own, besides going to church, okay? Psalm 111, praise ye the Lord. I will praise the Lord with my whole heart in the assembly of the upright and in the congregation. We're in the assembly of the upright and in the congregation right now. You need to stop thinking, I'm not coming against church or the church building or the people of any particular church, okay? What I'm saying is in the spirit we are the church already, okay, outside the box, outside the building. And you know that. So, praise ye the Lord. I will praise the Lord with my whole heart. We're doing that right now. In the assembly of the upright and in the congregation. No, we're not perfect in Christ. He's perfect, but he's always continually working on us and in us, okay? Until we go be with him or until he takes us out of this earth, the rapture or when he comes back, you know, the end time thing. But so just know that God continually works on us. Perfecting us, making us more like Jesus, and it's difficult at times. Don't get me wrong, it is not easy at times when God's working on us. But you know, if you're not saved, you don't have to be afraid of that, because the greatest thing about salvation is knowing that you are in Christ and you're on your way to heaven. Okay, and it will bear witness with your spirit. Okay. He's given everybody a spirit, and it bears witness with my spirit after I got saved. So let me go to verse 2. I might be all over the place on this video, and that's okay. So also I warn you that, you know, there's going to be offenses in the last days. There's going to be offenses all over the place. So try not to be offended. I'm not saying I'm not going to offend you. With what I say here, even me just being a woman talking about the Word of God on here is offensive to many people. And I'm not going to get into all that right now, but verse 2, Psalm 111, the works of the Lord are great. The works of the Lord are great, sought out of all them that have pleasure therein. Verse 3, his work is honorable and glorious, and his righteousness endureth forever. His righteousness endures forever. He hath made his wonderful works to be remembered. The Lord is gracious and full of compassion. He hath given meat unto them that fear him. He will ever be mindful of his covenant. He has showed his people the power of his works, that he may give them the heritage of the heathen. That's our inheritance, okay? The works of his hands are verity and judgment. All his commandments are sure. They stand fast forever and ever and are done in truth and uprightness. He sent redemption unto his people. He sends out his redemption unto us right now. He hath commanded his covenant forever. His covenant. Do a word search. Look up covenant with God and read about that and study it. Holy and reverend is his name. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. A good understanding have all they that do his commandments. His praise endureth forever. Okay, now I'm going to go over here to Luke 23. Okay, Luke 23, King James Version, public domain. I don't know how much of this I will read, but let's just see. So we've gone from the Old Testament psalms, praise and worship to the Lord with his word, over to now the New Testament. Luke 23, and the whole multitude of them arose and led him unto Pilate. And they began to accuse him, saying, We found this fellow perverting the nation and forbidding to give tribute to Caesar, saying that he himself is Christ, a king. And Pilate asked him, saying, Art thou the king of the Jews? And he answered him and said, Thou sayest it. Then said Pilate to the chief priests and to the people, I find no fault in this man. And they were the more fierce, saying, He stirreth up the people, teaching throughout all Jewry, beginning from Galilee to this place. I'm not going to read any more of this, okay? You can read the rest of Luke 23 on your own. It's very good. But when you read the Gospel, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, you're reading about Jesus Christ, okay? Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, you're reading about his life here on this earth, okay? And it really is an amazing thing when you start off, let's just say, because this is the way I do it, not telling you what to do. But I start off with the Psalms, praise and worship, just even a little bit, even one or two scriptures. Then if you want to go to Proverbs, which gives you wisdom, that's a great place to go. You can do one of those a day and go through the whole book of Proverbs, one proverb a day. You'll have so much wisdom. And then read a little bit of the Gospel, okay, the Gospels. Just a little bit even. I'm not saying stop it a little bit. I'm just saying just refresh yourself. Daily is the best thing to do. I'm not telling you to do this daily, but the best thing to do is daily, because it brings God right down into your life in a more stronger awareness, okay? And he will help you. He will help you. He'll be your GPS system, okay? Now let's go over to Galatians. Let me see. We'll just do Galatians 1. I'll just start a few verses of Galatians 1, and then we'll do something different maybe. I don't want to make this video too long. Galatians 1, Paul, an apostle, not of men, neither by man, but by Jesus Christ and God the Father, who raised him from the dead. Now let him speak to you through these verses, okay? And all the brethren, that's you, which are with me unto the churches of Galatia, grace be to you and peace from God the Father and from our Lord Jesus Christ, who gave himself for our sins that he might deliver us from this present evil world. And don't we need that today, according to the will of God and our Father, to whom be glory forever and ever. Amen. Now, this is such a great book, the book of Galatians. Lord, I just come to you right now and lift up the people out there. There's so many needs, Lord, but you know them all. In Jesus Christ, you're alive. And we need to believe that, Lord, that you're alive today. You didn't just be raised from the dead last Sunday that we celebrated, but you were alive before last Sunday when we celebrated Resurrection Sunday. You were alive before that day, and you're alive after that day. That's just a day we stop to celebrate, okay? And that's wonderful that we do that, and people all over the world do that. Now, Lord, I lift up this situation in Ukraine. Father, please help Putin stop. Just help him to stop, Lord. Sometimes we can't stop things on our own. We have to intercede for people to be delivered from whatever it is in his mind that he thinks that he needs to attack Ukraine, whatever. It's not right. It is not right. He can't justify it. He cannot justify what he's done. Okay? Now, when we're talking about these things, maybe the thought goes over to, well, you know, Bush and Iraq and stuff. And you know what? I supported, because I didn't know any better, but I support our troops all the time. But so this Iraq thing, I supported the president on it. I didn't want to see it. The night that they invaded, attacked Iraq, I wept with such convulsive weeping. And I wasn't weeping against us going there. I don't know what I was weeping for, but I was weeping. And I even called a doctor at the time, and I probably just really, man, he's going probably, he's, I put a message on his machine, and I'm going, I was crying and crying and crying. Now, later on, we learned that it was a false premise of going into Iraq. Now, at the time, I had studied a lot about Saddam Hussein and how cruel he was to the people. But apparently, now, do your own research on all this, but apparently he wasn't cruel to the Christians, or at least he let them be there, I think. But from the stories that I studied, there were other cruelties, like gassing his own people in the north, I believe. So I'm not going to get all into that, but then later on we really did learn that the intelligence was wrong about the WMDs, the weapons of mass destruction. And so I'm just saying, let's don't talk about that anymore. Let's just come against this cruelty right now for these people in Ukraine. And for whatever reason and justification he's using, I don't believe it's a justification of what he's done already. So I did tweet for the first time today to the Twitter account of him, please stop. That's all I said was, please stop. So I'm asking God to please help him to stop. Now, let's just pray over people that are addicted to drugs or anything else, vaping or cigarettes, things that are bad, alcohol maybe. I'm not coming against the letter of the law of doing these things. Don't get me wrong. I don't put you or anybody under condemnation for these things. I'm just saying God's people need help to be delivered from things, okay? Other things, mental illness. People need prayer over being autistic children. Okay, that's what I'm saying. I'm not condemning anybody for these things. I have my own problems. I have things in my life that I deal with, okay? OCD, ADD. Anxiety disorders, learning disorders, I'm sure. But anyway, we do the best we can, and we're not perfect. We're perfect in Christ because Christ is perfect, okay? So, Lord, I lift up families to you and marriages and situations that we are unable to deal with at times. It's too much. And so I'm asking Father God to intervene in the name of Jesus. Intervene in the name of Jesus. And touch your church, Lord, the body of Christ. Touch all the pastors, Father, as they study for tomorrow's sermon, for today's sermon, Lord. I'm sure there are churches, the Seventh-day Adventists, they meet on Saturdays mostly. I've been to that church. I'm not a Seventh-day Adventist, but I do feel that there is a, in the spirit, Saturday, a day of rest, okay? Do something different this day. Don't live under the letter of the law. The letter of the law kills. Even Jesus healed on the Sabbath day, so don't live by the letter of the law, which kills, okay? Father, help people be set free, including me, in areas, Lord. Help us to have a good day, Lord. Protect people. Deliver criminals from crime. We always come against crime, crime, crime. I come against it every day. Accidents, close calls, driving on the highway, those kinds of things. But Father, touch the criminals and touch them and lead them out of criminality, Lord. Touch prisoners, Father. Touch our leaders, Father, first of all. Lord, have mercy, and we give you all the praise and glory in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you for listening and watching, everybody. I apologize for the lighting. I know it's really bad, but it is what it is right now, and I have to deal with and I have to, it is what it is, okay? You know that. So anyway, thank you for listening, watching, and God bless you. Have a great day. In Jesus' name.